I have no idea what this is. You've got your bright red torch kind of right here. Check this. Wait, what? Hey guys, DfieldMark here, and welcome back to a brand new episode of Roblox Bloxburg. I hope you guys are all having a fantastic day today. We are back on the Bloxburg servers today, ladies and gentlemen, to go ahead and do another subscriber tour. I want to give a quick, huge shout out to my girl, KyleRanger101, just chilling right over here. Thank you so much for letting me tour your home. Guys, from what I've heard, this home has a secret. Now, before we actually get into the house tour and find out what that secret is, I want to give you guys a huge thank you for taking a quick second right now. Smash that freaking like button. I would truly appreciate it, guys. Let's go for 2 likes on today's video. You guys have been smashing the like goals on every single one of these past videos. Join the notification squad by subscribing and turning on the notification bell as well. Guys, honestly though, from the bottom of my heart, thank you guys so much for all the support you guys have been giving to the channel over the past couple of weeks. You guys have absolutely been killing it. Anyways, guys, let's go ahead and begin the tour. Once again, another quick, huge shout out to KyleRanger101 for allowing me to tour this beautiful Spanish home. Now, guys, before we actually go start, I'm going to go ahead and pan out and drop a couple of facts like I always do for you guys. This is what I am going to be calling the Spanish villa or the Spanish home, all right? So it's obviously a mansion, guys, as you guys can tell. And if you guys imagine, I don't know how many of you guys are very familiar with this show, but on Netflix, there's a show called Narcos. And literally, guys, on that show Narcos, it's based in South America. So like a lot of Spanish housing and a lot of Spanish mansions are shown in that show. And literally, guys, this is what it reminds me of, like the Spanish mansion, Spanish villa, the color scheme with the bright red roof alongside with just like how the windows and everything are created. It literally looks like an actual Spanish villa and I really love it. And then when she told me there was an actual secret or something special in the house as well, I was like, this is going to be the perfect house for us to tour for a video. Guys, really quickly, before we go ahead and start the tour, I need to make this quick announcement because a lot of you guys have been tweeting me pictures on Twitter. For those of you guys who send me your houses and I don't reply to them because obviously I get a ton of tweets from you guys every single day asking me to tour, I do apologize, guys. I can't tour every single person's house. I'm just trying to find amazing mansions, amazing creations that some people can find a little bit of inspiration from. Now, for those of you guys who have been following the Bloxburg series ever since the beginning, you guys all know that I started the series in order to get inspiration for you guys and for me as well. Now, all of us obviously here are Bloxburg players and we all try to, you know, create the best things that we can. And the best way that we can share ideas and do all that stuff in order to get inspired is by doing these house tours. So do not forget, guys, I do apologize if I'm not able to tour your house. There's just so many people asking to get toured at this point. I'm just trying to find the best of the best in order to make a really good and informative video for you guys. Anyways, without further ado, guys, let's go ahead and start this actual tour. Kyle Ranger, thank you so much once again for letting me tour the Spanish mansion or the Spanish villa. As you guys can see, everything well decorated. And honestly, guys, in South America, if you guys think of the mansions and stuff in there, there are only a couple of trees and stuff that are normally on these grounds. So it actually makes sense how her decorations are only just a little bit on the outdoor scene. Anyways, let's go ahead and step inside to the actual mansion itself. Looking to the right, it looks like we have a kitchen, and looking to the left, it looks like our formal dining room. The decorations around the entire house, guys, basically just completed, and you know, it's nothing extremely extravagant, but you know, it is a Spanish villa, and this is literally what I would expect from a Spanish villa like this. From my understanding, guys, a lot of Spanish villas in real life are actually furnished so that they do not have a lot of furniture everywhere. Basically, what their main goal is, guys, is to try to get as much airflow throughout the entire house. So there's a lot of openings, a lot of doorways, a lot of windows. That's basically what kind of, I guess, determines whether or not a Spanish house is good in South America. So as you guys can see, there are literally doors everywhere. She's got a mini garden over here to the left side. You guys can imagine living in South America with this house, a wonderful breeze just coming through the door and going throughout the entire house, just keeping the entire house fresh. But guys, check out the the color schemes of the entire rooms. You've obviously got the red roof, which kind of just symbolizes that Spanish mansion, that Spanish villa feel. And I really, really like it. And then obviously, guys, over here in the kitchen, you've got yourself a nice little standard kitchen here. A bunch of hot sauce, chilling out. Everything is well decorated. You guys see how the granite countertops kind of wraps alongside the wall like that? I really love that. You know, most of my kitchens that I've built have always been in like a straight square room with the countertops just kind of going around in an L shape. This one is perfect and different just because of the fact that it is wrapping around like a non-square wall. I really like that. I'm probably gonna end up using that as inspiration for a future kitchen build. I really do love it. Now over here, we've got ourselves another bathroom. I was actually expecting this to be like the pantry or something, but I mean, I guess it is her build, so it looks really, really nice. Nice little standard bathroom over here. You've got your toilet, you've got your shower, you've got your sinks, maybe add a mirror right here. You know, that would probably kind of complete this little room right here with a mirror. And then over here, you've got yourself what looks to be like the study or the library. Now, obviously, guys, this house is not the biggest. It's not gonna be the biggest library we've ever seen, but it's a nice little chill area. You know, you've got your couch here to read books on. You've got a desk over here to work with your computer, whatever you need to get your work done. And then over here, a bunch more tables and study desks with the library right in the center. When it comes to Bloxburg creations, guys, it really just all depends on your imagination. Every single room that you create can literally be anything that you want. Right over here, guys, we've got ourselves a closet built into the middle standard of the actual wall. You don't see this very often in real houses, but I feel like you should because the closet is literally right in the smack dab middle of the room. I kind of like it, to be honest with you. It's a nice little spot to keep some extra things like clothes and, you know, jackets and shoes. Anyways, guys, I'm pretty sure this thing right here is a brand new item on Bloxburg. I've never seen these door sensors. This is the first time I'm ever seeing them in action. It's actually so cool that this is in a Spanish villa, just because you walk through going into the backyard and it's like, welcome to paradise. You know what I'm saying? That's literally what it's telling me right now. And then over here, guys, you have a fantastically decorated, fantastically designed pool. It literally feels like the Caribbean back here. It is a little bit dark because it is nighttime, but let me go ahead and boost my energy and stuff real quickly. But guys, literally, there's just no better day to just be chilling in the backyard here in a Spanish home, and it just feels 100% complete. You know what I'm saying? Guys, I could definitely see myself vacationing in a house just like this in South America. It would be so freaking amazing. Now, Kyle says, be careful back here. There is a house on this back right corner, and as you guys saw, Kyle was saying, be careful back here. I have no idea what this is. It's kind of really scary looking. It's kind of away from the entire mansion. It's in the corner of the house all randomly. I have no idea what this is. You've got your bright red torch kind of right here. Check this. Wait, what? Wait, what? Is this a prison or something, dude? Wait. Please, just a screenshot. No problem, princess. Sure, no worries. I'm so sorry. Princess Ladybug, come take a screenshot. I don't mind at all. Go ahead and take it. Guys, I really do feel bad having some of you guys blocked on these little sections over here. But sometimes, guys, during the tour, I do need the house to kind of be a little bit more open than usual, because sometimes a lot of people end up blocking the actual area itself. So, princess, I hope you can get a screenshot by the end of this recording, or hopefully later at the end of the video itself. But guys, what the heck is this? It's literally a prison. Look at this. Like, you are trapped in a metal chair that is all rusted, and she's saying it's a jail. What the heck? She literally has like a secret jail in the backside of her house right over here to like torture and keep all of her freaking victims. Oh my gosh. You guys remember how I was talking about at the beginning of the video how this house reminded me of Narcos? For those of you guys who are not familiar with Narcos, it is literally a show about the old Colombian drug lords way back in like the 1980s or 1990s, I'm pretty sure. And just the fact that I've, you know, connected Narcos with this house just because of the way that it looks, because it's a Spanish villa, and then the fact that there's a jail back here, obviously, guys, those drug lords were like criminals and stuff, so it's kind of funny to find a torture room right in the back right corner of the house. So Kyle just said, I don't kill in there, no matter what anybody says, even if they're dead. Oh my gosh, there's the chat for you guys a little bit right there. there. What the heck? I've never actually seen a house have a prison for, you know, for torturing people and keeping people in place, I guess. Oh my gosh, you guys are just getting more and more creative. Now, on to the second floor of the actual house itself. Another nice, fantastically laid out area here. As you guys can see, you got a custom painting over here. Kyle literally said that she took this picture, so probably when she was visiting. I literally have no idea what this is. My first thought is that this is probably like London or something. Like, I'm pretty sure that's like the big tower that's like famous or whatever. Got a nice custom painting over here. Another perfectly furnished bathroom. I don't really see very many bathrooms with a shower and a bathtub in it, but it does look very, very good. I do like it. Now, one of the things I really do like about this actual master bedroom, guys, is the fact that there's this middle section right here. You guys see how she used pillars right in the middle of the room? I really love the way that they did that, and especially when I do my next mansion build, I am definitely gonna use this sort of feature in my master bedroom to kind of make the room look a little bit bigger and also separate the two rooms into like a sort of like a chill area and then the actual sleeping area itself. So that is something in this house that has currently inspired me to do something else. Over here, guys, we've got ourselves a nice little bedroom, very fully furnished out with the same color scheme as the Spanish villa that we've been going for. Very, very nice. As you guys can see, the decorations and the way that everything is laid out is very, very relaxing. When you imagine a Spanish villa, everything is nice and open with the rooms being very small because obviously people are wanting you to spend time outside. Like, you don't want to spend time inside when you're on vacation, you know what I'm saying? So anyways, over here, got yourself a nice little music studio. I feel like she could have chosen a different set of lights for this music studio, but hey, at the end of the day, it looks pretty freaking nice. I do like it. And then over here, we've got ourselves another, this looks like the kids' bedroom right over here, guys. The kids have a nice massive bed, a whole bunch of toys and stuff to play with as well. Guys, honestly, you guys are all getting so much better with decorating houses, decorating rooms, making sure everything is fully furnished. You guys have honestly blown all of my own expectations out of the water ever since I started the series. I never thought that I would be touring houses as crazy as this. On to the third bedroom, we've got ourselves another bedroom over here with a nice little bathroom as well. Overall, guys, I think she did a fantastic job actually building this house. The only thing that I could probably add in comparison to all the other houses we've toured is maybe just add a little bit more decorations and paintings everywhere. But that being said, obviously this is a Spanish villa, so the decorations should be slightly different. Maybe my expectations are just slightly off of what they actually should be. Now, guys, onto the last floor. This is the third floor of the entire villa, as you guys can see here. Over here to the right, you've got yourself a nice little study on the third floor of the entire house, just overlooking the entire front side. Nice little chill couching section over here, and then a computer as well. And then on the left side, one of the biggest bedrooms. This is probably considered the master bedroom of this entire place, guys. Nice little bed over here, looking into the double fireplace. I love how you guys have all started using fireplaces indoor or fire pits indoor. Looks so freaking cool. I love it. You guys have honestly all done such a great job with your recent builds. And what the heck is this? It's like, oh my gosh, it's like a walk-in closet that just never ends. Just so many clothes right here. Kyle, another huge shout out for going ahead and letting me tour your fantastic mansion here, guys. Show Kyle some love in the comment sections below. I appreciate you letting me tour this fantastic house. Thank you guys so much for watching today's episode of Roblox Bloxburg. If you guys did enjoy, make sure you guys hit that like button for me. I would truly appreciate it. My name is DField. We will see you guys again tomorrow for some more daily Roblox content. Have a fantastic day, everybody. Peace.